In my hair video, I showed the way I tie my hair using my homemade DIY snag-free elastics. And one of you, Mabel, Lucy, Anna, you expressed that you wanted to see me demonstrate how I make these. So it's very simple, and I shall fulfill that request for you.
And all right, so this is the best I can do with my setup. Hopefully it's going to suffice. I have a pair of old tights, pantyhose. And so it's very simple. I start at the toe, the foot, and I'm not delicate about this. You'll notice that about me. I just cut the toe part off completely, put that to the side, and here we start, and you're gonna get a ton. What I love about this DIY is you're recycling and upcycling, as it were. And so I like to cut it all different widths, but I'm going to cut, there's one, and as you stretch it, it rolls in on itself and becomes a perfect hair tie that is completely smooth, as you can see. And this is what I use to tie my hair. Yep. It's actually really nice and pretty. And I just keep going. Doesn't have to be perfect. I just snip it, stretch. There's another one. Really wide ones like this. Really wide, because when I wash my hair, I don't blow dry it, I let it air dry. And the way I get it very smooth like this with a natural like wave that you see, when my hair is about 80% dry, still damp, I bring it gently to the back of my head and I roll it in a bun and I just really loosely wrap it with this. Not even twice around. I will just take one of these really wide bands that I make and place it over my hair. And I go to sleep like that. And in the morning, this is the result. So I washed my hair last night, actually. And in the morning, you can see it's bouncy and it has a nice natural, I guess, shape to it. That's from wrapping my hair and sleeping on it in this. So my hair is protected, it's out of my face, and these serve me so well. So I just go up the entire length. I don't have to show you anymore because you just keep snipping away. There's another one. And I go all the way up the leg. Each leg, so you're gonna get a ton. This yields a ton of hair ties. And then when I get to the waistband part, I'll show you on the other, because I've done this so many times. I did it with a taupe pair of tights, and this I made into a headband. So this I use, and I tied it in a cute little bow. I made another one out of this teal color, which is really pretty. And so it's so smooth and soft against my face and my skin, and it doesn't give me a headache because it's not tight. And look how stretchy and nice and elastic this is. And it's smooth, completely smooth. It doesn't pull my hair. And it actually looks really stylish when I'm wearing them. So I've made a ton because I had so many tights that I wasn't wearing or that had snags in them, so I couldn't wear them on my legs anymore because they're all holy. And I made my own hair ties because the reason I do this also is self-explanatory, but I don't enjoy store-bought hair ties because they always have a connector, and even the ones that say snag-free, they're glued. So that little knot of glue snags my hair, and I don't appreciate that. I don't want my hair I don't deserve that. So I don't want my hair to be pulled out by my hair ties, but because I have long hair, It's not practical for me to have my hair down all the time. In fact, I almost always have it up, unless I'm just in the mood to have it down or I've freshly washed it and I'm wearing it down. So there you have it. Simple as can be and free, because these materials came from my closet and I am recycling and upcycling, and I can feel good about that. And this tutorial, I guess if you want to call it that, hopefully it was helpful to you. And you'll see me in my next one. Do this and tell me if you do this. And I'm just kind of curious if anyone's going to actually do this. I love them. So enjoy.